Hello Boost Nation and others, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about great Boost Mobile feature, and that is Booster. Two reasons I picked up this topic today to talk. The first one, in the prepaid market, only Boost Mobile is offering that feature. If you're talking about Metro, KirkKit, Total Wireless, Simple Mobile, none of them has it. Only Boost Mobile is offering it. And the second reason, the majority of the Boost Mobile customers are unaware of it and they are not going for it. So let's start and spread the awareness. So Booster is a Boost Mobile financing. Hold on, we are not talking about the traditional financing, in which you finance $500, for example, and you might ending up paying up to $1,500. And if you don't pay them, they might mess up your credit. So Boost Up is truly free of credit check. How me are you can sure that they don't check the credit? They're giving you phone, how come without checking the credit? They're not asking you the social security number. Whenever you're going to do the booster, first of all, you have to be approved for it. So once you're approved and you are ready to go for it, social security number is not required, it's optional. If you give them, they'll take it. If you don't give them, it's still you can do it. So that's how you can ensure that there's no credit check in the bank, like the traditional financing companies. So what is the criteria to be approved? Your loyalty with Boost is the only criteria to be approved for Booster. What does it mean? How Boost Mobile can check our loyalty with them? If you pay your last 12 month bill payments, that's a year, last 12 month bill payments on time, you did not miss any, you are automatically approved. So let's talk about its eligibility and requirements. Only existing Boost customer can do the Booster. And you should be on a monthly plan. If you are on a daily plan, system not gonna approve you. You're not eligible automatically anyway. If you're in a family plan, then only primary line can do the Booster. To do that, you have to be 18 years or up. And if you're living in Alabama, then 19 years. And you should have your valid ID with you while you're doing it. And in past, if you ever did financing with the Sprint and you did not pay them off, then the system will not approve you automatically. So let me give you an example to understand how Boost Up is different than other financing, and what are the good things which makes it different than the others. So the first thing in Boost Up, they finance the up to $600. So for example, if you're purchasing $1,200 phone, so think about that, you are going to down $600, and remaining $600 they can give you financing on that. So let's take an example. The phone original price is $450, and on that time that phone is a dollar down. In Boost Up, there is a whole list of the phones which are dollar down, so you're going to pay dollar down plus the tax upfront of the entire sales tax of the device. So 450 plus dollar down 451 plus sales tax, that's 490 or 91, 92, something like that. And the sales tax, as you know, varies according to state. I'm giving you a general idea. And it's 18 months of financing. And it tells you how much is your down payment and how much you're going to pay monthly. So over here, is in this example, it's a dollar down and $25 a month for 18 months. So if you multiply 25 multiplied by 18 for months, so that's $450 plus one for the down. So that's $450, and you put tax on it. This is the amount you're going to pay in 18 months. So now think about it. These days, where everything is based on interest, Boost is giving you phone today, you pay off in 18 months while paying the original price. You're not paying any hidden charges. There's no other games. That's the simplicity and the good thing in Boost app. So installments. So you got the phone on Boost app. You made the first payment, initial payment already. So how are you going to make the monthly payment? It's with your monthly plan. Whenever your bill is due, you're going to make the payment in the store or online. So whatever is your monthly plan, $50 or $60 or whatever, plus add your installment. So in this example, it's $25. So $50 plus $25. That you can pay cash or card. That's very simple on that. So this one situation comes in Boost app. You know, the people, they say we be paying our bill for more than a year on time and we never miss any payment. Why we are not still eligible for Boost app? You know, the good thing is for financing always, like it doesn't hurt your pocket. You don't have to come with the whole money, so you can do down and you can take any phone you want. So that customer might have the grace period. That Boost Mobile used to do it, they don't have it anymore. Like that was also for a loyal customers, and in case like if you for any reason, any emergency, you couldn't make the payment, you couldn't go to the store, you were not able to access the internet to make the payment online either. So your line stays active after your due date, and company give you 14 days extra. It's not basically extra, because once you make your payment, company will minus those days from your remaining monthly days. So if you have that, you might have it. If you're saying you paid your 12 months but you're still not eligible, you can call customer care to find out. You can visit Boost Mobile store, so they can remove it, and it takes 3 days. So that's the only situation comes in. And if you have your ID with correct information and your name in the Boost Mobile account, and on the ID is matching, address, everything is matching, and then it will go through process is easy. You know, sometimes in Boost Mobile is prepaid company, customer, they use their incorrect names, now maybe accurate name, you know, like in postpaid company. So at the time of Boost up, it would be better to fix your information in the Boost Mobile account. You can go on boostmobile.com, you can change over there, and you shouldn't have any problem. So that's pretty much. If you have any question regarding Boost app, you can write down a comment. I would love to reply on that. So that's it. Stay safe, take care of yourself and my channel.